Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to this video lecture of Wireless Cellular and 4G LTE, module number 3, lecture number 8 on channel structure of LTE. So in this particular topic of channel structure, we will see how the multi-antenna transmission will help in achieving the quality of service, okay, achieving the very good reliability, how flexible the transmission will be if we use more than one antenna, okay. The term multi-antenna is nothing but making the number of antennas by one to more, okay, or making more number of antennas for the transmission, okay. So whatever the topics we have studied in the microwave and antenna subject, okay, so where we have seen if I make use of more than one antenna, we call it as an array of antenna, okay. And we know what are the various benefits of using array of antenna, right? If I use one antenna, then the transmission it becomes a kind of like the strength of the signal power will be required, will be more, okay. So if I make use of array of antenna, okay, it is almost like making use of your MIMO systems, right? Multiple input and multiple output, okay. What are the various benefits of using multiple antennas, okay? So now today we will see how this multiple antenna transmission will help in LTE systems, okay. So basically what we have seen in yesterday's class is the downlink shared channel, okay. So in downlink shared channel, the basic concept was like what should be the channel encoding, okay, whether the physical layer whatever we have at the base layer, okay, because if you take off your OSI model also, right, there are 7 layers, okay, but when it comes to the transmission, all the signals should be transmitted through a physical layer, okay. So that physical layer plays a very important role. Okay. So that is the reason whatever we do here is it should be such that the transmission rate should not fall. Okay. Even though if there is a huge traffic. Okay. Basically this happens. Okay. I will give a very small example before the before we go with this multiple antenna transmission. Okay. For example, I am the transmitter, and if there are four receivers, okay, whatever the data I transmit, it becomes the uplink kind of activity, okay, and whatever the receivers who receive the signals will become the downlink activity, okay. Now if I activate my internet connectivity and if I ask the four receiver to turn on their hotspot or to turn on their wireless LAN, okay, the same thing we do with our mobile phone also, right, just turn on the Wi-Fi, okay. So whatever the password and the username whatever I share with the four receivers, it will be connected to four receivers, will not be connected to all the receivers, okay. And the more the number of receivers increases, okay, then automatically there will be a traffic in the data, okay. Traffic in the data is nothing but the rate of transmission, the rate of reception of the data get reduces, okay. Why? Because all the four receivers are connected to one transmitter. Okay, it is just like 1:4. Transmitter is only one, but the number of receivers are 4. Okay, so during that conditions, it becomes very difficult for the receivers to receive the data. Okay, sometimes the data may get lost because there is a huge traffic. Okay, and whenever there is a traffic, obviously there will be a slowdown in the process. Okay, so taking care that the process should not be slowed down. Okay, and there should not be any traffic, or there should be enough traffic such that the channel handles all the transmission data. Okay, so that is why the reason we go for multiple antenna transmission or multi antenna transmission. Okay, and when it comes to the physical layer, okay, it should support all the MIMO modes. Okay, basically there are various modes are there in which are specified in the LTE system, and we will see one by one how this various modes of MIMO system, that is multiple input and the multiple outputs modes, will help our for the LTE for multiple transmissions. Okay, in order to make this LTE transmission modes to be used in a very effective manner, okay, we try to place the transmission, or we try to describe the transmission of the various MIMO modes. Okay, and there are total 7 transmission modes which are defined for the data transmission on this particular channel. Okay, this is shared channels. Okay, physical data shared channels also you can call, or you can simply call it as physical data link shared channels. Okay, there are seven different transmission modes we have. Okay, so the first mode here is single antenna port, denoted by port zero. Okay, what this single antenna port will do is one transport port block is transmitted from a single physical antenna corresponding to antenna port zero. Okay, for example, if you take an example of your the embedded boards, okay, like Arduino board, okay, or the Raspberry Pi, okay, or simply you take 8051 microcontrollers, okay, or you can take 8086 microcontroller board or microcontroller chip IC. Okay, basically we have four ports, okay, four IO ports also you can mention, right? And those ports will be acting as either input port or the output port based on the signals whatever you give, right? So therefore here the very first port here in the multiple antenna transmission is single antenna port, denoted by port zero. Okay, and this port zero is responsible for the transmission of only one transport block. Okay, single physical antenna corresponding to antenna port zero. Okay, if you want to increase the number of ports or more number of ports, then you have to use the other different ports which are assigned to that particular antenna. Okay, then the second different type of transmission mode is it is transmit diversity. Okay, so what do you mean by the word transmit diversity? Here is one transport block is transmitted from more than one physical antennas. Okay, that is what the transmission antenna says. It is making use of MIMO modes. MIMO modes in the sense multiple input and multiple output. There are many inputs and there are many outputs. Okay, so what I will do is, for example, if I have one transport block, right, and if I have many antennas, so what I will do is I will not transmit my data from only one port. I will transmit my data from multiple ports, multiple outputs. Okay, from that is called as more than one physical antenna. Okay, because the number of physical antennas are many. Take for example, there are five physical antennas are available, okay, which are acting as the transmitting antennas. Okay, so instead of transmitting the first transport block or one transport block to the first antenna, what I will do is I will transmit my data or the transport block from all the five physical antennas. Okay, so that is port 0 and port 1. Okay, if two physical antennas are used, that is what the number says. There are n number of in IO ports I have said, right? Port 0, port 1, port 2, 3, 4, or pin number 1, pin number 2, pin number 3, pin number 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, based on the input IO ports. Similarly, here also, if there are two ports, what I will do is I will transmit my one transport block from two ports. Okay, if I have more than two, I can go for either zero port, port zero, port one, port two, port three. Okay, if four physical antennas are used. If you have five physical antennas, then the number will be increased to four. That is 0, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, 0, 1, 2. And 3, and the last is 4. So 0 to 4, that particular 0 to 4 will be acting as the transmitting antennas for one transport block. Okay, for one transport block, you require minimum how many antennas? 4 antennas, sorry, 5 antennas. Okay, so this is the second mode. Now, the third mode here is open loop spatial multiplexing. Okay, now we know what do you mean by the term called as a multiplexing, right? Taking the multiple inputs and transmitting over a single block or a single channel. Or okay, so here one or two transport blocks are transmitted from two or four physical antennas. Okay, what was the case in point number two, that is transmit diversity, was I'm having only one transport block and I'm transmitting one transport block to four different antenna. Okay, now what I will do is I will increase the number of transport block from 1 to 2. Okay, from 1 to 2. Okay, so during that conditions, how many physical antennas I require? Okay, so the number of physical antennas will be either they can be 2 or you can take it as 4 also, 2 raised to 2. Also, this also you can do. Okay, so in this case, the only the thing is you need to predefine. Okay, that is port transport block 1 and transport block should be transmitted to port 0. transport block 1 and transport block should be transmitted to port number 2. 3, transport block 0 and 1 should be transmitted to port 3 and similarly port 4. Okay, so during this, when this condition or when this scenario comes, okay, what we should do is we should predefine the precoder matrices. Okay, precoder matrices, just like your truth table matrix, right? For example, if you have 2 bits for the representation, then how many combinations we can do? We can do 4 combinations, that is 2 power 2 is equal to 4. It starts from 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1, right? So therefore, those 4 blocks are nothing but it is my matrix. Okay, it is my matrix. Okay, of how many, like 2 cross 4, or you can simply take 4 cross 2, that is 4 rows and number of columns are 2. So therefore, you need to predefine the precoder matrices that are used based on the rank indicator feedback. Okay, that based on the whatever the matrices we get by using some kind of precoder, okay, you need to assign those matrix number by making use of rank indicators, right? Just like you are giving some priority, you should do. For example, if there are 2 transport blocks, that is transport block 1 and transport block 2, but transport block 2 is having more weightage than is more important than compared to the transport block 1, then what I should do is I should assign the transport block 2 first, then transport block 1. Okay, so that is nothing but based on the rank indicator feedback, the matrices will be defined. Okay, and the precoding matrix is fixed and is not adapted. It is, the matrix will be always fixed, it will not be changing all the time. Okay, then that was open loop spatial multiplexing. Okay, and the another type of spatial multiplexing we have is closed loop spatial multiplexing. Okay, now again, here the case is something different. Okay, if 1 or 2 transport blocks are to be transmitted from 2 or 4 physical antennas, this is the same case. Okay, the precoding in this case is adapted based on the precoding matrix indicator. The earlier was rank indicator feedback. Now here it is precoding matrix indicator feedback from the user entity. Okay, it is almost similar. Only the thing is the matrix from rank indicator will be changed to precoding matrix. Then the next type of mode, multi-antenna transmitter mode, is multi-user MIMO systems. Okay, now we will not see about the physical antennas. We will see about the number of users, number of user entity, or number of mobile phones, you can say. Okay, if the 2 user entities are multiplexed, okay, onto 2 or 4 physical antennas with 1 transport block to each. Okay, one, they are telling that, for example, there are 2 mobile phones and these 2 mobile phones are to be multiplexed. They need to be they should be combined. Okay, if you want to combine and then you want to transmit by making use of 2 antennas or by making use of 4 antennas, we will not see how many antennas are available for the transmission. We are now focusing on the number of user entities. Okay, suppose if there are 2 user entities, okay, and you have 2 or 4 physical antenna, but the condition is that you have only 1 transport block to each user entity. Okay, sometimes what happens is for user entities you may have more number of transport blocks. Okay, but now the condition is only 1 transport block each user entity. Okay, so therefore what should be the total number of transport blocks overall is nothing but 2, because 1 user entity has 1 transport block. But the condition here is 2 user entities are multiplexed. So 2 user is equal to how many transport blocks? 2 transport blocks. Total transport blocks are 2. Okay. So now these 2 transport blocks have to be multiplexed. Then what should be the rank? What should be the precoding matrix indicator? Okay. So the rank 1 precoding matrix indicator feedback from each user entity is used to create the overall precoding matrices. Okay, so based on the number of transport blocks, based on the number of user entities, we go for defining how many number of transport channels should be assigned for transmitter antenna. Okay, then the next type of mode is closed loop rank 1 precoding. Okay, this is one of the special case of the closed loop spatial multiplexing. Okay, you can see here, right? Closed loop spatial multiplexing. what we have done is we are making use of PMI. Okay, so this is the special type of PMI, or you can simply call that is closed loop spatial multiplexing with single layer transmission. When it comes to the single layer transmission, then the rank of the matrix or simply or the range of the matrix is given. Pre-coder is nothing but pre, p cross one. Okay, that is applied to the pre-coder. Okay, and the last type of mode is multi-antenna mode, is single antenna port denoted by port number 5. Okay, what is port number 5? Is a single transport block is transmitted from two or more physical antennas. This is applied to all the modes. Okay, the E node B performs beam forming into a single user entity using all the physical antennas. Okay, in the sense, if there is only one physical transport block is available or a single block is available, this single block will be transmitted through all the transmitting antennas, or you can simply call as all the physical antennas by making use of beam forming. Okay, you know what do you mean by beam forming with respect to the antennas? Okay, so there is a concept called as a radiation pattern. Okay, you need to calculate the what is the beam forming by using the power transmitted or the received power, in terms of you have a power PR, that is received power is equal to the transmitted power into the G divided by 4 pi R square. Okay, you can use the formula and simply you can calculate the particular radiation pattern in terms of the, even you can go for the angle. Okay, and based on that angle, you can tell what is the amount of degree or what is the angle which is being formed by making use of that radiation pattern. Okay, so other than the other modes, what we have seen in the upper definitions, okay, other modes, this single antenna port, okay, it has some kind of reference signal reference signal is also transmitted using the beam forming vector, okay, that is used for the data symbols. Okay, this is just like you are transmitting the data along with the cyclic prefix. Okay, same thing here also, we will not only transmit the data symbols, we also transmit some kind of reference signals. Okay, reference signal, it is just like the signal has been has come from so and so particular antenna. This is just like a kind of a authentication type of. Okay, if the reference signal get matched, then the received signal is 100% correct. This is how we try to identify. Okay, so therefore this type of mode, that is beam forming technique, is used at enhanced node B in the transparent, which is almost transparent to the user entity, and the user entity can able to decode the transport block with the help of user specific reference signal. That is what I said. Okay, we have seen the concept of the encryption and the decryption, right? So once you are encrypting your data, okay, once you are encoding your data with some key, with some public key or the private key, okay, it has to be decrypted using the same particular key, same reference signal, same reference point, same reference bit, okay, such that the data, whatever you decode, it is 100% correct. Okay, same thing is done in multi-antenna transmission. Okay, other than that, the beam forming can be used, okay, to improve the received signal power or to reduce the interference signal power. That is what the main important concept of beam forming. Okay, it will show you what is the amount of angle which is formed by the radiation pattern, and when you calculate the angle, even from that particular angle or the radiation pattern, you can calculate the received power signal, received signal power, or simply you can say what is the amount of power which is received, okay, out from that particular angle which is made by the radiation pattern. Okay, why this is important is because in the wireless communication, okay, the cell structure is hexagonal, right, and we need to take care that there should not be any loss of power at the cell edges. Usually the power losses will be more at the cell edge because of its shape. Okay, so making sure that there will not be any loss of power at the cell edges, okay, due to any kind of interferences. Therefore, the signal power has to be calculated based on the beam forming technique. Okay, so this is how all the 7 different modes are covered in multiple antenna transmission in downlink shared channels. Okay, so with this, I will conclude this multi-antenna transmission technique in LTE